Hello and assalamu alaikum to everyone. I'm Nazia Amir and going to discuss the third major area of administration, which is record management. Record refers to the informational documents utilized by an organization in carrying out its various functions. What is record management? The activity is designed to control the life cycle of a record from the time it is created to its ultimate disposition. Record management refers to the field of information management, which is concerned with the systematic analysis and control of operating records kept by organizations. Effective record management is extremely important for businesses because records in any form are vulnerable to loss resulting from disaster, inadvertent destruction, theft, misfiling or mishandling. Record management again. Although the primary focus of records management remains paper documents, the modern office has witnessed problems of information storage pertaining to non-paper records, including photographic negatives and prints, microfilms and videotapes. Similarly, computer-generated records are also in important records category. The administrator role. It is very important for any administrator. In organizations where a formal records management program is in operation, the administrator performs a liaison role, providing records management staff with essential information and office files. However, in organizations where there is no formal records management program, the administrator assumes full responsibility for records management activities. It's important to realize that although some aspects of record management require specialized technical expertise, many record management concepts are based on common sense and an orderly approach to problem solving. Managing records. It's also a very important part for any record management. Records can broadly be classified into two categories, active records, inactive records. The administrator should realize the significance of both types of records and must develop a clear understanding regarding the filing procedures for them. Logically, active records should be kept in easily accessible locations, while inactive records may be kept in a safe location but should still remain relatively accessible for future use. Active records. Active records are referenced on a daily basis and thus should be constantly available and updated. Example, attendance registers. Inactive records. Inactive records are referenced only for a brief initial period of time, maybe once or twice shortly after creation, but may never be consulted again, like correspondence and office memos. Similarly, legal and technical project files may remain inactive for a long duration before they are required again. The records inventory, which is also a very important step for any record management. The administrator should maintain a records inventory, which is listing of all types of records a company has, how long these items are kept, where are they located. Record scheduling. The administrator should maintain a retention and disposal schedule that lists the time period for which given record types are to be retained, for records to be discarded. It further specifies the date and security precautions required. The objective of maintaining such a schedule is to highlight it that the records created and maintained by a company are its property and are not to be discarded without proper authorization. Retention periods. With reference to retention, records fall into one of three groups: short term, medium term, and the long term. Now I am going to discuss in detail. Short-term retention. Records which are needed for a brief period but have little continuing utility and will be discarded a short time after their creation, such records are retained in office locations until discarded. Medium-term retention. Records which are needed for a specified period of time, maybe 1 to 5 years, but will eventually be discarded. These records are kept in office locations for a brief time and then shifted to lower-cost off-site storage facilities from where they are eventually discarded. Long-term retention. Records which are to be retained indefinitely. In many cases, such records are microfilmed to save space and the original paper document may be discarded. Although all records are vital, but some are more important than others. Approximately 1-3% business records are vital and include insurance policies, documents of partnership or incorporation, certifications, license, leases, deeds and titles, tax returns and supporting materials, warranties for office equipment, computers and machinery, copyrights. The other vital records, personal records, financial records such as accounts and receivable balances, banking and payroll records, pension and profit sharing documents, work and data processing backup tapes, and this company policy manuals and departmental procedures manuals. Record centers. A record center is a warehouse type facility designed specifically for the economical storage of inactive medium-term records pending their eventual destruction. An essential feature of such a center would be its storage facilities. Normally, the record center would provide various office departments with standardized containers along with instructions for packing, labeling and inventorying. The record center would accept records as indicated in the retention and disposal schedule, and thus it is the responsibility of the administrator to ensure that only those records are sent to the center which have been authorized for medium to long term storage. Micrographics. It is also another form of record management system. Micrographic and microimaging are terms used for reproduce information in reduced form on film. This is the preferred alternative for records designed for long-term retention. In this process, records are photographed onto film so that numerous small images will appear on a reel of 16mm or 35mm film. These images are viewed in enlarged form on a microfilm reader. Many organizations are switching over to micrographic for active records as well. By miniaturizing records, micrographic can make them more accessible and easier to handle. Microfilms are an excellent method for storing both active and inactive files since they take up only one-third of the space needed for paper documentation. They save space and money. In addition, they are more durable, can be easily duplicated and mailed. Now I am going to show the record cycle. It starts from creation, then usage, then storage, then disposal, / archives. Now I'm going to discuss in detail. Creation stage. It is the exertion of control over the development and adoption of new forms and records. New forms and records should be developed only when a definite need can be subsequently justified, and when new forms are designed, careful attention needs to be given to their design. At this stage, it's also important to determine the length of time records should be stored before their destruction. Number two is the utilization stage. This stage of record cycle is concerned with developing efficient procedures in order that desired records can be retrieved and delivered to the desired location at the desired time. The effectiveness with which a document is utilized in this stage is greatly dependent upon the quality with which information is entered on the document in the creation stage. The third one is storage stage. This storage involves efficiently utilizing filing equipment and the space occupied by the equipment. For the greatest efficiency and convenience, records should be stored in a location accessible to those who utilize them. Safety of records is also important. The retrieval stage. It involves repeatedly locating requested records in addition to singling out documents when removed from the file. Retrieval also involves tracing documents not returned to the files within a reasonable length of time. The last one is disposition stage. This stage involves preserving valuable documents, especially those that are vital for the smooth operation of the organization. It also involves the transfer of records from high-cost storage area to low-cost storage area, as well as the proper destruction of records no longer having any value to an organization. Micro recording of documents is also an important function of this stage. Filing system. It is also an important system for any record, and it's very much similar for any record management system. And it is fast, error-free, subject filing, color coding. You need a logical system. We file for retrieval. Here I am going to show the basic filing tools. Take charge of your desk. A desk is not a filing cabinet, nor a windowsill. Manage your desktop so that it is clean. Clear it by end of day. You will have more energy when working. Inside your desk, retain items you use weekly. Minimum items mean more efficiency, less clutter, and greater your sense of control. And in the last, I'm just giving you the importance of record management system. Provides accurate and complete information, control records, solves the record related problems, provide records management services at the least possible cost without sacrificing efficiency, standardizes record handling, make clear to employee the value of well-developed record management system, protects the confidentiality, enable periodic evaluations of the record management program. Here I am going to end my video. If you like my video, do not forget to subscribe my channel and press the bell icon so you can get notified when I post new content. Thank you.